on the internet nowadays, underrated is a word that gets thrown around a lot in the gaming space. But it's not hard to see why. Sometimes it's easy to forget the larger world and only see what's in front of you. I don't know if it's something about the online gamers' incessant need to be a part of something that the masses don't know about, or just a general sense of inclusionism the human race loves to feel, but I hear the term underrated thrown around on games that no one would really disagree with. Games that are well-liked in their individual communities or just not all that special are suddenly these underrated gems. But when I say underrated today, I mean it in complete earnesty. Hey everyone, I'm Arvy Rocks, and Nintendo has a lot of franchises that don't get the attention they deserve as much as they should. Mario, Zelda, Kirby, Pokemon, Animal Crossing, unless you are one of these five series, your position as a Nintendo franchise classic slash priority is in the air. We've seen it time and time again. Franchises oft forgotten about, your Rhythm Heavens, your Metroids, your Star Foxes. While regarded by many fans as Nintendo classics and some of the best series Nintendo has to offer, they are often underappreciated by their daddy of development. But what if I told you that there was a Nintendo franchise that is overwhelmingly great? A Nintendo franchise that has a depressing, melancholic story. A Nintendo franchise that has four games already in its lineup. And most importantly, a franchise that has yet to be forgotten by Nintendo. Well, that series exists. And its name is Box Boy. Developed by HAL Laboratories in an effort to harken back to the simplistic days of Kirby's earliest outings, they came up with the idea of just using boxes to traverse puzzles. And while this game did in fact start as a Kirby game, very quickly they realized that Kirby and producing boxes from his body don't really mix as well as they had hoped. Cause after all, we're not talking about this, we're talking about this. These development decisions, alongside box production being a main mechanic, led to a simplistic world with simplistic gameplay and a simplistic premise, but it manages to be deep in application. Box Boy has four games spanning two consoles, and they are all essentially building on the same concept, creating boxes that are the same shape and size as your body, and how that can be applied in a multitude of ways across a variety of puzzles. The first game has you doing just that. In the second game, you can make two sets of boxes. In the third game, you get some special boxes that have different but unique properties to them. And in the fourth game, you get two characters who can make boxes independently of each other, as well as a character who is not completely square, adding more depth to the puzzles that can be completed with just these boxes. As I said earlier, it's a simplistic system, but it's one that can be applied in a mind-numbing amount of different possible outcomes. A ton of people praise games like Mario Odyssey for their ability to always have some new gameplay ready, so many different game ideas, but never exploring them more than they have to avoid letting it get stale. Well, this idea also carries over to Box Boy. Every game has a core gimmick of sorts, some spin on the box creation formula that gives each game a unique identity, but within these games, that same logic I mentioned just a second ago still applies. There are so many different ideas this game throws into the mix, and they never sit long enough for you to get sick of them. For the most part, each world has a gimmick, and then you don't see that gimmick again till the bonus worlds at the very end of the game, at which point you already haven't seen them for a while, and they mix them all together for posterity's sake. This vast wealth of level design makes these games feel like one long experience as opposed to several small games. And don't be fooled, these are shorter games. On How Long to Beat, each one clocks in at about 10 hours for full completionist, and that stands to reason with my time in the games as well. But with that short length comes a great positive. These games are nigh impossible to burn out on. Unless you decide to marathon them all at once, they each have their own niche within the small realm of box creation. My biggest negative for the series as a whole is that it takes a while for each game to really pick up. The first three worlds of each game are impeccably easy in comparison to the difficulty that comes from the later worlds. And yes, I said difficulty. HAL Laboratories, or more specifically Kirby, is known for making games that lack challenge and are a breeze for the player. But Box Boy doesn't fall into that standard trapping. Of course, difficulty is subjective, especially for a puzzle game, but some of these puzzles had me head scratching for long periods of time, more so than you'd expect from a game that looks like this. And speaking of that, the looks. As stated earlier, this game was meant to harken back to the days of the NES and Game Boy Classic, so they gave it a completely monochromatic art style and simplistic character designs. And oh my god, are these character designs adorable! I really love the look of QB in particular. He's literally just a square with two dots and legs, yet he manages to express so much personality with no dialogue. He is adorable, and like, look at his amiibo. Now look at the price tag. And now look at my face with anguish, knowing that I will never have him. The simplistic art style also lends a lot of benefits to the original trilogy's home system, the 3DS. A lot of 3DS games can look, well, for lack of a better term, pretty gross when going for a more ambitious graphical style. For example, Kid Icarus Uprising is a fantastic game, but one that could really use a graphical facelift, benefiting from the power a more traditional console would give you. And even the best looking 3DS games look really blech once you take them off the 3DS screen. But with its simplistic art style, BoxBoy circumvents this issue and never really looks bad. There are definitely parts that are murkier than others, but this art style never makes you feel the limitations of the 3DS, and in my books, that's always a win. Even playing it today when there's a BoxBoy game on the Switch, the older games look and play as great as ever. And I feel it bears repeating that while this game's art is remarkably simple, it manages to be so adorable in execution. Kinda like another HAL character. Although this one's a bit more colorful. The series is monochromatic throughout most of the first game, but this means that the few times that they do actually go out of their way and use colors, it's that much more special. And then as you go throughout the other games, you see the color seeping more and more into the world around them. It's a design choice that may look incredibly shallow at first glance, but as you go through the game's story, it makes more and more sense. And that brings me to the story. And honestly, while it mostly takes a backseat to other things this game has to offer, I really don't want to spoil it. I mentioned earlier that it was dark and melancholic, and it's true. It is, and that might be a spoiler on its own, looking at the characters and the world the game has presented you. It's hard to tell how exactly the game is going to be that way, but when you get there, you kinda just have this empty feeling in your stomach. So for those who are interested, go experience it for yourself. I don't wanna take that moment away from you any more than I already have. And you know what? Even if you don't wanna know the game's story, play it anyways. It's small, it's cheap, it's short, and you won't be losing that much to try it. The first game is $5. And if you don't love it, it's $5. But if you do love it, you have 3 more games, also at lower than average prices, to sink your teeth into. And if you're anything like me, you will be hooked. And if you are hooked on this video, then why don't you subscribe to RV Rocks and ring the bell, like this video, and go on to comment your favorite Nintendo franchise that you think deserves more of a spotlight than it already has. Nintendo is one of the lucky few gaming companies that has so many IP that people perceive as one of the big ones. But very rarely do they all get a moment to shine together. So I'm curious to hear what you guys think are the best of the neglected. Be sure to let me know your thoughts on this video or any other RV Rocks content either in the comments or on Twitter at RV of Rocks. But before you do any of that, I have been RV Rocks and thank you so much for watching. See ya! Let's